Hi guys, I had another question. Why does my urine have a strong, stinky odor? Okay, we're gonna talk about that. Now, if you are not on a ketogenic program and you're not doing intermittent fasting and you have that odor, it could be a urinary tract infection. It could be liver damage. It could be you're eating the wrong foods. You're not having enough vegetables, okay? But if you are on a keto intermittent fasting program, it could either be the ketones that are not being burned coming out. Initially, when you're adapting to ketosis, there's this transitional period of a keto adaptation. And in that process, you're gonna have more ketones coming out of your urine. And sometimes it's a bit stronger than it should be. But when you do it a little longer, you'll be burning those ketones because your system is more efficient. And chances are you're not gonna be eating as much fat because your body is more efficient. So what's gonna happen is you're gonna have burn up more ketones and less odor over time, okay? Now, if it's ammonia, like that would be the smell of, you ever have one of those CDs that you would stick in your car or some type of CD player and you take the plastic off? The smell of that plastic is kind of ammonia type smell. It's like a chemical-y type smell. Now, this usually is too much protein, okay? So what are you gonna do to kind of counter this kind of nasty smell? There's a couple things. Number one, you want to support the liver with certain types of vegetables. For example, you want to do more beet tops in your salad. A real good one would be dandelion greens. Okay, you get them at the health food store. You can get them in your backyard, but just make sure if you have a dog, you know, it's clean because sometimes they urinate on those little weeds. But this weed, the dandelion greens, is amazing for liver rejuvenation, okay? So you wanna have some of those bitter greens for the liver. And that will actually clean up a lot of the odor, especially if it's ammonia or actually even ketones. You want to start to make sure you have enough fluids. So you know, don't go the whole day just with like a half a cup of fluid. Make sure you consume, you can put electrolytes, but just drink a little bit more fluid because especially when you're doing keto, it acts as a diuretic and you get rid of excess waste that way. So it's kind of cleaning, but you need to replace some liquids as well. And then if you're exercising on top of that, you probably need more fluids. But my whole point is don't drink more than you're thirsty for, but make sure you're having enough. The other thing is you want to adjust your proteins. I don't recommend doing the Atkins diet, which is heavier on the proteins or a high protein diet. It's called moderate protein, 3 to 6 ounces. If you have too much protein, you're definitely going to have more ammonia type smell. All right. And lastly, chlorophyll is a great deodorizer. It's a detoxifier. You can get liquid chlorophyll. You can use my wheatgrass, this stuff right here. 1 teaspoon is a whole tray of wheatgrass. And it just helps to purify and clean the system. So it's high in chlorophyll and it'll actually counter that bad odor. All right. Thanks for watching. Hey, if you haven't already subscribed, press this little button down below. Okay. Thanks.